You might be wondering, what the hell is this? Or what is it good for? I'm going to answer your questions in a second, but let's play a little game. Let's say you have 5 boxes in your room. Each box has 4 cards in it. A card could be 0, 1, 2, or 3. Now you stand in front of the box, pick a card, write down the number, and put the card back in. You do the same thing with all the other boxes. You're going to end up with a combination of 5 numbers. The goal of this game is simple. Write down every combination that you can possibly have. For example, in some off chance you might get 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. You reset and play again. This time, in some off chance, you might get 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. You reset and play again, and you might get 0, 0, 0, 0, 2. Now start writing these numbers down until you've covered every single possible combination. Luckily, I've already done it for you. Each horizontal line represents a box. Each vertical line represents a card inside the box. The yellow mark represents the card that you picked up. It's a lot simpler than it looks. All I've done is write a single procedure and repeat itself over and over again until I've gotten all the combinations. In our example with 5 boxes and 4 cards, we have to repeat 1024 times. In your math class, your teacher is going to call this permutation with replacement. And if you Google it, you're going to find something like this. It's a calculator that will give you the total number of possible outcomes. And depending on the rules of the game, you have different versions of calculators. For example, you might decide that the order of the combination doesn't matter. If you do so, 001 is the same as 100. Or maybe you might decide that once you pick a card, you cannot have a duplicate of that card. The more rules or exceptions that you have, the less total number of combinations you're going to get. But let's get back to our visualization, because that's probably a little easier for you to understand. Where would you use something like this? The most obvious example is gambling. If you're designing a lottery system, for example, you might decide to have 5 boxes and 69 cards. Your chance of hitting the right combination would be 1 out of 1,564,031,349. Now, in most lottery systems, the order doesn't matter, so your chance might be higher, like 1 out of 15,020,334. Now, on top of that, if you add one more box, your probability of winning decreases dramatically, even if you decide to only have 26 cards in that particular box. I haven't visualized this, but let me know if you want me to. Other various examples include items in your video game. Let's say you have an empty weapon slate. Let's say you can add 5 different attributes to this weapon. If you decide that you cannot have duplicate attributes, then you're going to have less possible combinations. In some games, you'll notice that you have combinations inside combinations. But whatever the total number is, the general idea is usually the same. The rarity, or value of that item inside your game, depends on the off chance that you're going to get the exact favorable combination that you want. Obviously, modern video games tend to be a lot more complex than a typical card game, and you're going to need a lot more than just a permutation equation. But possibly it's one of several things that decide how balanced or difficult your game is. Or for puzzle games, it might be a critical deciding factor. Congratulations on watching the video this far. If your head is spinning at this point, don't worry, because I'm going to simplify this. Remember one thing that I said. All I'm doing here is defining a single operation that repeats itself over and over again. Once you define that correctly, you can write it a million times without making a single mistake in your math. So in the next video, I'm going to explain that one procedure, because again, it's a lot simpler than it looks. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.